السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. All thanks and praise are due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and may His peace and blessings be upon His last and final messenger, His family, His companions, and those who follow them until the end of times. Inshallah, everyone is doing well. Tonight's principle is found in the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Seek the life to come by means of what Allah has granted you, but don't neglect your rightful share in this world. Now this is a very important principle related to our success in the life of this world, but more importantly, in the life of the world to come. And this principle is mentioned in the context of the story of Qarun, who was an extremely wealthy and arrogant individual from the people of Musa alayhi salam. It's a story that portrays the power of wealth and knowledge, and how when coupled with arrogance and ingratitude, leads to destruction, loss, and ruin. And in essence, Surah Al-Qasas, it depicts those values that make wealth and luxury practically insignificant when compared with faith and righteousness. And it also highlights the importance of moderation in enjoying life's pleasures without arrogance or corruption. So in this verse, in this principle, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us the proper attitude and mindset we're supposed to have when it comes to wealth and material possessions. So first, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is encouraging us to use our wealth and whatever He has blessed us with in righteous causes. To use our wealth for good works instead of wasting it or being miserly and stingy with it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, seek instead, by means of what Allah has granted you, the good of the life to come. And what that means is spend and use our wealth while focused on the life of the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us autonomy over money. We earn, we own it, and we can spend it. But when spending it and when using it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, what we should have in mind is the life of the hereafter. So we should use that wealth in the proper ways and avenues. We should spend it in charity, building places of worship, building schools, taking care of the sick, weak, needy, orphans, and widows, helping out those who are less fortunate, helping out the homeless. As the well-known saying goes, the life of this world is the land that is cultivated for the hereafter. However, there is a very, very beautiful balance to the divine guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In addition to encouraging us to be charitable with our wealth, we are also reminded, وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. But don't forget your rightful portion or your rightful share of this world. We are entitled to enjoy our wealth and certain pleasures and delights of this world, but within certain boundaries and limits that have been set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows human beings better than they know themselves. He has made certain things attractive to us as human beings, things that we're naturally drawn towards. There are certain enjoyments, certain pleasures, certain delights, certain desires, entertainment that we are allowed to partake and participate in. We're allowed to enjoy certain types of food and drink, clothes, homes and marriages, and any other material possession you can think of. But it's important to recognize that we're allowed to enjoy these things within certain limits, within certain boundaries. And that is our portion from the life of this world. And it's important to recognize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has rights upon us, but so too do our bodies, our families, and our friends. And we're supposed to give each sphere of our lives its due right. As a matter of fact, one of the defining qualities of Islam and Muslims is balance and moderation. If there is one idea, if there is one concept that can be used to describe Islam, it is balance and moderation in terms of theology, practice, morals, values, ethics, and principles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. We have made you a balanced and moderate nation. And there are several ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam where he encourages us to be balanced and to avoid excess and to avoid extremes. So for example, it's narrated that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam entered upon a particular companion and he said, "Have I not been informed that you offer prayer all night and fast all day?" So the companion said, "Yes, Ya Rasulullah." The Prophet ﷺ said, "Don't do that. Offer prayer at night, but also sleep. Fast for a few days, and don't fast for a few days, because your body has a right upon you, your eyes have a right upon you, and your guests have a right upon you, and your wife has a right upon you." In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, "Ad-deenu yusrun." Religion is ease. And whoever overburdens himself in his religion will not be able to continue in that way. Whoever tries to overburden themselves, right, in terms of practice, they will not be able to sustain that. They will not be able to maintain that. So you should not be extreme, but try to be near to perfection and receive the good tidings that you will be rewarded and gain strength by worshiping in the mornings, the afternoons, and during the last hours of the night. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma said, "Work for this world as though you would live forever, and work for the hereafter as though you were to die tomorrow." That is a very profound statement. Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma is saying, "Work for this world as if you're going to live forever, but work for the akhirah, work for the hereafter as if you're going to die tomorrow." And that is that balance, that is that moderation between the life of this world and the life of the hereafter. And this balance and moderation in spending is one of the qualities of those who are described as Ibadur Rahman, those who are described as servants of the Most Merciful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَنْفَقُوا لَمْ يُسْرِفُوا وَلَمْ يَقْتُرُوا وَكَانَ بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ قَوَامًا. They are those who are neither wasteful nor stingy when they spend, but keep to a just balance. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us this balance and moderation, to help us develop the right attitude and mindset towards the life of this world, where we are using the means of the life of this world within their boundaries and limits, but our main focus and our main goal is on the life of the hereafter. Wa sallallahumma ala nabiyyina mawlana Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.